Hello students, welcome to my 25th video. In this video I am going to discuss the question answers of this lesson that we have already completed. Now before that, of course, you must know what are the things required to be done in the copy once you start writing the question answers of this lesson. So first, the name of the lesson. Then you can draw a small squirrel. Seeing the picture from here, after writing the name of the lesson, this picture you can draw in the copy. After that, word meanings, divide them into three columns. One column the word, then the meaning, and then the part of speech. After that, you will write a very short summary of the lesson, a brief summary regarding what the lesson contains. And then you will move on with the question answers. Now let us see what different categories of questions we have. First we see under question A, one extract is given with three questions. Then we have another heading B, under which we see long answer type questions. So these two we are going to discuss today. So let us begin with A. Answer the questions with reference to the context. This is the extract given here from the lesson. Tippity was the means of my solving a problem in natural history regarding which a controversy raged for many months. This is the extract. Question 1 is, what was the mystery? Now we know what was the mystery. The mystery was that the walnuts in the Himalayas were found with holes, and it was expected that those holes were made by the birds which were called the nutcracker. The biological name is Nucifraga hemispilla. So that is what the mystery was. Those walnuts were the credit of making holes on the Himalayan walnuts was given to this bird, the nutcracker. So that was the mystery you will mention here. Second one, how did the author solve the mystery? Now what he did to solve this mystery? The author, he placed some walnuts under a tree where a pair of nutcrackers used to come. Now when the birds came, they did not attempt to break them. Those walnuts which were kept there, the nutcrackers did not attempt to break them. He then, what he did, placed walnuts with holes already made by Tippity under the same tree, and then the nutcrackers came, and what he observed that those birds began pecking at the bored walnuts. The walnuts which were having holes, the birds started pecking on them. So that is how he was able to solve the mystery. Next one, why did the author want to solve the mystery? Why he wanted to solve the mystery? Because there was a controversy going on this particular natural history for which he wanted to solve. So that is why he tried to solve this mystery, because he wanted to solve the controversy which was going on from many months. Let us see now what is given here. We see there are 8 questions given, long answer type. So under B, first question is, describe Tippity in your own words. Now this is something I would want you to do. Write it yourself. You have to describe Tippity in your own words, the things that are given here, the sleeping habits, the eating habits, the toilet routine, all those things will come under, but in brief, so that you will mention in this question 1. Question 2 is asking, why did the writer find Tippity's nocturnal nature to be a drawback? We know what is nocturnal nature, though that the nocturnal animals are the animals which are active at night and they sleep the whole day. So this tipiti belong to that particular category of animals. So why the narrator found this to be a drawback? We know that for him it was a drawback because tipiti was lively and active during the night and was sleepy in the daytime, and at the night time it was active and lively when it was the time for the other people, for the ordinary people to go to bed. So that is why the writer found this to be a drawback. Next one, why would tipiti sometimes sneeze and sputter while drinking milk? Why she did that? Now we know that tipiti was not very ladylike when milk was offered to her. She was much in hurry for finishing her milk. Like she never enjoyed her milk. Instead, she used to try to finish it in hurry. So in that hurry, she used to put all her face in the saucer, and that used to, of course, some part of the milk used to enter in her nose, and which made her sneeze and sputter whenever she drank milk. So that you will mention here. Next one, explain the phrase, would have done credit to an animal 10 times her size. Now what would have done credit to an animal 10 times of her size? We know the sound that she created, the growling sound, that was very much high pitched and annoying, and it looked as if the sound was coming from an animal which is 10 times larger than her size. So that is why this phrase is made here by the author to exaggerate on the pitch of the growling sound that she made. It was so much highly pitched, looked as if animal which is 10 times bigger in her size is making that sound. So that is the meaning here. Next one, why was it in the writer's interest to provide Tipiti with a good dinner? Now we know that at night she used to become active. So to avoid that, the author used to provide a good dinner, and that also the favorite of Tipiti, so that she overeats her dinner and then feels sleepy after overeating and goes to sleep. So that is why he used to provide her with a good dinner, which she used to overeat, and then she used to feel sleepy and used to go to bed and used to sleep till the early hours of the morning, and that used to give a good sleep to the author as well. He also used to have a good sleep once Tipiti went to bed. So that is what you will mention. Next one, question 6 now. Give two examples from the passage to show that Tipiti was not very choosy when it came to eating. Now that we see here, once they went for the afternoon stroll, there we find that on her way back, she used to nibble at the young leaves. So you can mention that here from here, the two examples where we can make out that she was not very choosy. One you can mention here, that she would make her way to the extreme end of the branch. You can find this line here. She would make her way to the extreme end of a branch and nibble off the young leaves. So that also shows that she was not very choosy. And second, you can mention here that the next one, she was quite happy on any tree or shrub and found something to eat on all. So that shows that she was not very choosy when it came to eating anything. So that you will write down. Next one, question number 7. How do we know that Tipiti wasn't too keen to accompany the writer on his afternoon strolls? How do we know? because whenever they plant, the they means the writer and the dogs, the two dogs used to go out for afternoon stroll, Tippity was being ruthlessly pulled out for out of her box. Is she here given? So she was ruthlessly, means without her willingness, she was pulled out of her box to go with them. So this shows that she was not very keen, not very interested in going for afternoon stroll. That you'll mention. Next one. Why would Tippity get tired up before meals? Why would Tippity get tied up before meals? Why she was tied up? Because she used to move around. She used to move around when they all sat for meals, and she used to spoil the food, the soup, and destroy the taste of soup as well. So that is why she was tied up, so that the family could have their meal peacefully. How did this practice ultimately lead to her death? Now, we know that one day when she was tied up with a chain, she managed to unfasten that chain and started hopping around in the veranda, and the other end of the chain was still tied in her, in one of her leg. She was moving around, and that was the moment when a fox caught her and she met with her death. So this practice, because of that chain, that weight of the chain, she was not able to run fast or hop fast to save herself. So this was the reason why she ultimately met her death due to that practice. So that you will mention here. And this much for you to write in the copy, A and B. And also I want you to see this part of your book, where I find very interesting thing for you to do. Well, these are the nouns given: surgeon, chef, veterinary doctor, explorer, architect, spacewoman, archaeologist, biologist. You have to write down the meaning looking into the dictionary. One is done here. A naturalist is one who studies animals, birds, and plants. The rest of them you are going to write in the copy, and of course you will find out the meaning from the dictionary. So that is what you are going to complete in your copy. First, the name of the lesson, a good drawing of Tippity, of the same posture, or any other drawing of a squirrel that you can find out, the flying squirrel. Make that. After that, word meanings, a short summary after word meanings, then question A, question B, all these eight questions you will write in the copy, and after that, this I want you to write in your copy. So this much for today. Take care everybody, and God bless you all.